Ladies and gentlemen, you know, I've been around a while, and I've been around the Clintons more than anybody should ever have to be. A couple of years ago, Bill and Hillary camped out in my state telling anyone who'd listen why they ought to vote against me. Tonight, I'm here to return the favor. I'm a patient man. As a young child in the South, I was struck with polio and forced to stay off my feet for 2 years. That experience taught me an abiding gratitude for my parents. And it also taught me how to wait, which comes in handy when you're the leader of the U.S. Senate. More than anything, though, my job has taught me the value of trust, how to distinguish between people who are in this to serve others and people who are in it for themselves. I'm here to tell you, Hillary Clinton will say anything, do anything, and be anything to get elected president. And we cannot allow it. The American people are tired of hearing about the bounty of government while the cost of caring for a family or meeting daily expenses grows out of reach. Over the past few years, they've seen government abuse their office and get rewarded for it. They've seen the middle class actually shrink. And in the midst of this, they've raised a very simple complaint. Who's looking out for us? It's not Hillary. I've had my differences with Barack Obama, but I'll give him credit for this. At least he was upfront about his plans to move America to the far left. To the far left. Not Hillary. She lied about her emails. She lied about her server. She lied about Benghazi. She even lied about sniper fire. Why, even she lied about why her parents named her Hillary. So I ask you a simple question. At a moment when so many feel betrayed by their government, why in the world would Democrats put forward such a candidate? Hillary has changed her positions so many times, it's impossible to tell where the conviction ends and the ambition begins. In 2010, she said Iran could enrich uranium. In 2014, she said she's always argued against it. Once a backer of the Keystone Pipeline, last year she opposed it. She used to be against sanctuary cities, then she claimed she was for them, and now we're not sure where she is. Friends, not since Baghdad Bob has there been a public figure with such a tortured relationship with the truth. Fortunately, there's a clear choice before us, and it's not Hillary. You know what the next 4 years will look like with Hillary, and you know that if Hillary is president, we'll continue to slide, distracted by the scandals that follow the Clintons like flies. 2 years ago, voters delivered a clear verdict on the Obama years by sending a freshman class of rock star Republicans to the Senate and delivering us a majority that I promised to make you proud of. We'd never hesitate to confront the president, but we'd also do the hard work of tackling urgent problems head on. And we delivered on that promise. We put Obamacare repeal on the president's desk. He vetoed it. Donald Trump would sign it. We passed a bill to finally build the Keystone Pipeline. Obama vetoed it. Donald Trump would sign it. We passed a bill to defund Planned Parenthood. Obama vetoed it. Donald Trump would sign it. And on that sad day when we lost Justice Scalia, I made another pledge that Obama would not fill this seat. That honor will go to Donald Trump next year. So with Donald Trump in the White House, Senate Republicans will build on the work we've done and pass more bills into law than any Senate in years. We've already passed the first major education reform in more than a decade and ended Common Core. We made the first significant reforms to Social Security in 3 decades. We passed a crucial cybersecurity bill. We imposed sanctions on North Korea. We passed the first major highway bill in more than a decade. We passed a bill to combat the scourge of human trafficking. And just last week, we passed the first major law aimed at confronting the heartbreaking explosion of heroin and opioid abuse. So, my friends, keep the Senate in Republican hands, and we'll continue this work. And the remarkable public servants that I'm proud to lead in the Senate will not let you down. But put Hillary Clinton in the White House, and I promise you this, she will double down on the cynical approach that Senate Democrats seem to revel in these days. Here's what I mean. As we sit here tonight, a terrifying mosquito-borne illness threatens expectant mothers and their babies along our southern coast. And just last week, Clinton Democrats in the Senate blocked a bill aimed at eradicating that virus before it can spread. And they weren't finished. They blocked a defense funding bill, a bill that would support the brave men and women who are right now defending us overseas. What in the world do these people think public service is about? I don't know. But I know this. If Hillary Clinton is our president, nothing will change. So tonight I ask you to continue. Let us continue our work. Let us put justices on the Supreme Court who cherish our Constitution. Let's keep the Senate. And let's elect a president and a vice president who really believe America is exceptional. Thank you, my friends, and God bless America.
Ladies and gentlemen,